Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm rendering exposition of Hebrew 5, verse 11 onward. Warning against apostasy. About this, we have much to say. And it is hard to explain since you have become dull of hearing due to letters, you know, letter make you dull. If you are in spirit like the Gentile, your ears are open, they are no more dull. University professors, their ears are dull. They can't hear gospel, they can't understand gospel. They only understand letters. For though by this time you ought to be teachers of the moral law of Moses, that means before the arrival of Jesus, you are just teachers of the moral law of Moses, you need someone to preach and not teach you again the basic principles. The principles pertain to His word. Moral laws have no principles. Moral laws are in black and white stated. The principle behind the moral laws is known to the rabbi. That is called oral Torah. So here Jesus come to give us lessons in oral Torah, basic principle, His word, of the oracles of God. The gods are oracles, there you get it by revelation on individual basis. Nobody can give you gospel. Gospel is your own effort. You need milk, not solid food. Babies, you know, they need milk, not solid food. And you are accustomed to under your rabbis. Rabbis teach you letters, that is milk. And you used to them as in university when the students are taken. In first year, they say they teach them the Old Testament, which is letters. They feed them on the milk. And next year, they say we teach them New Testament. So how can they, when they are fed up with the old wine, how can they desire the new? No way. For everyone who lives on milk, scripture is unskilled in the word of righteousness, meat of Jesus, since he is a child. You need to have teeth to chew the meat of Jesus. That is why at 30, the apostle, the people who got baptized by John the Baptist, they were between 25 to 30, sensible people, not children. But solid food is for the mature, for those who have their powers of discernment. You have discerning intellect, you know, only the meat is for them. Trained by constant practice to distinguish good from evil. So those who can distinguish between good and evil and tell the rabbi that they are hypocrites, only then good, you know, this is what is written. The people of age 30 or so become mature enough to perceive hypocrisy among the temple priests and get hatred of them. Remember, Peter was once born, he could not identify the hypocrisy of the temple priest so well as the other. He did, you know, because his brother Andrew showed him, you know, what these temple priests were doing. But he himself was very simple-minded. Their parents, being old and dead in the system, will object to your outspoken remarks about the rabbis. Their parents have been told, you know, don't say anything against your rabbi. Remember the man who was in the graveyard. He was a man of discerning intellect. So he was pinpointing the hypocrisy of the village rabbi. But the village rabbi was upset and he told his dead in spirit disciple, go and lock him up. Which your parents treat them as their masters. You know, the parents always treat them as master. That's why Jesus said, unless you get rid of your parents, that they don't influence you and become solitary, you have no part in me. Disciples are slave to their rabbis, as the university students are to their professors. Hebrews 6, 1 to 12. Therefore, let us leave the elementary doctrine of Christ and go on to maturity, not laying again a foundation of repentance from dead works and of faith towards God. So these are confusing, you know, this whatever, let's make sense out of it if we try. But you know what, we are royal priests, you know, and we deal with His word. We preach gospel, we don't teach. We have the knowledge of oral Torah and of instructions about washings, washing of hand, you know, laying on of hands, resurrection of the dead, and eternal judgment. Now, most of the people, they don't know the difference between resurrection and reincarnation. So, and this we will do if God permits, for it is impossible in the case of those who have once been enlightened, who have tasted the heavenly gift and have shared in the Holy Spirit. Impossible. Oh dear, it's all mucked up, you know. And have tasted the goodness of the word of God and the powers of the age to come. And then have fallen away. Then could make sense, you know, if they have fallen away, you know, then it's impossible to restore them again to repentance, because they do it knowingly, you know, once you have fallen away. When you are twice born and you got fallen away into Judah Iscariot type Muhammad worshipper, then you can't come back to God because you done it knowingly. It is not forgivable. The person who is once born, he can make mistake and he is forgiven, but not twice born. Since they are crucifying once again the Son of God to their own harm and holding him up to contempt. So sometimes they use the, you know, those who are Muhammad worshippers, they use Christ Jesus as a tool to fleece people. They will show the statue of the cross, you know, with icon and other thing to the people. Oh, yeah, look, this is the Christ. And they will then steal money from them and they make a following, blind following. And anybody who make a following in Jesus, he's antichrist because he can't give his account to God. For land that has drunk the rain that often falls on it and produces a crop useful to those for whose sake it is cultivated, receive a blessing from God. But if it bears thorns and thistles, it is worthless, near to being cursed, and its end is to be burned. The idea, you know, once you get rain, he's comparing rain to the grace of Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is given to the people, and then if they misuse it and start fleecing people like Judas Iscariot, then, you know, is a curse on them, you know, because Holy Spirit was given to them to produce wheat plants, not to produce thistles and thorns. This is, I have done this today, this table, which I show you what it means by the twice born. This is in the description, you know, this table, and here you are, this the person is a twice born here, and this is producing holy father. This is evil fathers, evil spirits. Judah Iscariot went here, money, greed. So this is what he's talking, you know, this man who uses the Holy Spirit is compared to rain that produces wheat. And here you have, he is producing tares, curses, you know, tares, not good thing, fleecing people in the name of Jesus. Those who were faithful to Abraham and Yahweh had the blessing of rain. They produced, they were salt of the earth and crops. But when these chosen people became Jews outwardly, swearing or breaking their covenant with Abraham and Yahweh, then the same land became barren and the people were forced to leave it, as during the Exodus. That is the curse, you know, when you misuse the Holy Spirit. Though we speak in this way, yet in your case, sons faithful to Abraham, beloved, we feel sure of better things, things that belong to salvation, the gospel treasures. Not this worldly treasures, money, but gospel treasures. When you want gospel treasures, then you don't take money. Those priests who take money from the churches, they are Judah Iscariot in sheep's clothing. They are putting their hand in the church purse at the end of the month. Hey, my salary. They are not working for God. They are hypocrites of the first degree. For God is not unjust so as to overlook your work. If you preach for gospel for God, he is not unjust. He rewards you as he rewards to me. Every time I found something new. And the love that you have shown for his name in serving the saints, as you still do. Serving the saints mean that these people, you know, they put on robes, you know, became saints, you know, and people used to bring them bread and all that. They were turning stones into bread, not those, you know, crook. And we desire each one of you to show the same earnestness, to have the full assurance of hope until the end. But if these people are blind guide, where will they take you? Nowhere. So that you may not be sluggish, but imitators of those who through faith and patience inherit the promises. So the you know, the salvation is through faith and not through works. So if you preach gospel with faith in God, then he gives you treasures which nobody can value. They are invaluable treasures. And our Father God blesses you.